This May in Toronto, more than 30 industry-leading speakers dedicated to printable, flexible, and wearable electronics deliver their knowledge to more than 250 participants gathered at a conference and trade exhibition held at Centennial College. The event served as a networking opportunity for those dedicated to printed electronics, including developers, industrial companies, and end users. The intent was to share ideas on overcoming technical, manufacturing, and scale-up challenges to commercialize new products and applications. EP&T took the opportunity to listen to a few of the participants.
Volterra is a desktop circuit board printing machine. Essentially, it allows you to go from a concept to creation in minutes. And so you can design your circuit boards, your circuit designs in any CAD tool you're already familiar with, whether that's Eagle, Altium, Paz, whatever. We take Gerber files as input, and we can print you out a circuit board on FR4 within minutes right on your desk. Electronics fab hasn't really changed much in the last 40, 50 years. You're using these factories, usually overseas, and the technology is pretty set, but it's really interesting the kind of opportunities that printed electronics affords kind of an established industry. There's a lot that you can do with these new materials and with new substrates, opening the doors to much more accessible, flexible electronics, electronics on glass, and all sorts of different materials with other functional properties as well. Standard rigid FR4 circuit boards, that's our bread and butter, but we're also really excited to help companies innovate and try different things because our platform is built for experimentation.
There's been a huge increase in the awareness of printed electronics, and especially, I mean, we're in a niche within printed electronics, the whole 3D side, and I would say in the last 12 months there's been a huge uptick in interest, a lot more pull from the market, a lot more awareness. I mean, you hear a lot about, Internet of Things. You hear in Germany about Industry 4.0, communication between dumb devices, making things smarter, everything's communicating, that means more antenna, more electronics, and for us, that's obviously helpful for our business because people are looking to put electronics in places where they're not traditionally put. So that gives us an opportunity then to grow with that.
We think that electronics manufacturing could benefit in a number of ways from print electronics. Number one is we think that electronics can take up entirely new form factors, can become flexible, conformal, stretchable, even three-dimensional. We think that printing electronics also gives us a route to integrate functionalities in new ways. So bring together not only electronics functions, but sensors, flexible batteries, even some optical features. And do that not just in a kind of tiny confined space, but be able to spread out these functionalities. Think of aircraft wings. It is potentially a platform that you could become on demand. So electronics manufacturing could benefit from a digital process to create even locally products and create networks of factories that take up much smaller footprint than conventional factories. So it could change radically the ecosystem of how electronics looks today. And it also gives an opportunity for new participants to come in, like printing companies, for whom it's very, very exciting.
Well, describing the importance of the printed electronics sector is not a very easy task to do because it's pretty diverse. If we go back and you look at photovoltaic, which is a subsection of printed electronics, it's already quite large. It's $1 billion plus printing industry. Now you try to get into these other areas, such as maybe medical. This is a growing field, and there's a substantial amount of business out there already. And you get into supply chain and tag packages, it's still pretty small. There's security components on the packaging industry, pharmaceutical requirements, and that still is lagging behind expectations, I would say. But I do believe it will come.
The value of networking is not only understanding what your colleagues, competition, your collaborations, your partnerships are doing, but it's also about learning how we can provide value to the industry, not just today, but also in the future. And I think the importance of what we're doing today is still learning and still enabling and educating other potential clients, customers, and partners so that we can see that ramp rate and that continued innovation in a business that really in 10 years will not look like it does today, but what we do today provides that foundation for growth.